Human predators populate our society. Psychopaths are human predators. They coerce, manipulate, lie, steal, defraud, abuse, and take life without feeling guilt or remorse. A leading expert on psychopathy, Robert Hare, estimates that 1% of people are psychopaths, while the clinical psychologist Martha Stout suggests this figure is closer to 4%. Studies indicate that psychopaths are overrepresented in the corporate executive world and in politics. Engage in immoral acts that fly under the radar of the criminal justice system. They will abuse family members or neglect their well-being. They will cheat others out of money, pathologically lie, or manipulate others for selfish ends. Most psychopaths are not incarcerated. They are out here in the world with you and me. The reason most of us refrain from routinely exploiting and harming others is because we possess a conscience. We empathize with the suffering of others, and if we make another suffer, we feel guilt. Psychopaths have no conscience, and they lack the ability to feel empathy and guilt. In fact, a psychopath does not feel love, friendship, or any emotional connection to anyone at all. A person who functions without the restraints of conscience. If you think about it, you will realize that what is missing in this picture are the very qualities that allow human beings to live in social harmony. The most seductive stimulant for a psychopath is power. No matter whether they are a career criminal, an unemployed freeloader, a middle manager, a CEO, a financier, bureaucrat, or politician, the mind of the psychopath is obsessed with controlling other people. Or as Martha Stout explains, the prize to be won can run the gamut from world domination to a free lunch. But it is always the same game, controlling, making others jump, winning. On the social stage, psychopaths often appear normal. In fact, they tend to be more charismatic, charming, and confident than most people. This social allure is partially a function of the fact that psychopaths experience far less stress, fear, and anxiety than the rest of us. But it is also the result of the psychopath's remarkable capacity to lie about their past, their achievements, and their character in a manner which mesmerizes and sometimes psychologically paralyzes their victims. Luckily, there are cracks in the psychopath's mask of sanity. One of these cracks is a pathologically inflated sense of self-importance, which psychopaths find impossible to hide. Or as Robert Hare explains, psychopaths have a narcissistic and grossly inflated view of their self-worth and importance, a truly astounding egocentricity and sense of entitlement, and see themselves as the center of the universe, as superior beings who are justified in living according to their own rules. Psychopaths find it difficult to maintain a coherent narrative. Their statements are often contradictory and littered with inconsistencies. They tend to jump from one unrelated topic to the next, and when asked a question, they are known to respond in a way that is irrelevant to what was asked. Psychopaths are notorious for not answering the question posed to them, or for answering in a way that seems unresponsive to the question, explains Robert Hare. Some psychopaths also accompany their speech with exaggerated hand movements. While psychopaths have plagued all societies throughout history, the problem of their existence is amplified by contemporary trends toward political centralization. Governments are reaching their tentacles into ever more areas of life. Global institutions are attempting to place the entire world under the same yoke of tyranny. And developments in technology are creating the potential for a form of totalitarian rule that is far more invasive than anything that has come before. As psychopaths crave power, as they are naturally charismatic, skilled liars, and unconstrained by empathy, fear, anxiety, and guilt, it is reasonable to surmise that some psychopaths gravitate towards, or are actively established in, positions of political power. Under such conditions, no area of social life can develop normally, whether in economics, culture, science, technology, administration, etc. Pathocracy progressively paralyzes everything.